Okay, and then it won't work. Okay, yeah, it works. Welcome. My name is Rolf Berkenbos. I'm working at Duo, dienstuitvoering onderwijs. A lot of people are saying, are you working for the government? Is that not really boring? It's absolutely not. I have a lot of fun there at Duo, a lot of fun with college. We're working with new technologies, and also we using a lot of Python because we support a lot of DevOps teams there, and the DevOps teams need a platform for it. So we're creating that for them. I really don't like to repeat myself twice with commands, so we did a lot of automation on that with Python. My Python skills is Python level is beginner because I'm just starting more and more with Python. So, and yes, I also tried to automate my wife with Python, and I will tell you later on more about that. This is the main topics that we want to cover. First of all, I have a question for you. Who is using Home Assistant of has? No, does know what Home Assistant is. Okay, and few people. Okay. Second question: who has ever did a commit to GitHub or send something back to the community? Also, quite some people. Okay. First of all, to talk about home automation. If you talk about home automation, I think it's a little less of a buzzword, like the cloud. It's a word, and you see that a lot of applications are creating for home automations, like Tone, the Tone thermostat. It's something like home automation, but you have also the Nest from Google. There's also something to do with home automation. There's also an app for that. If you have your light from Philips, it's a Hue light. You have a Hue app. If you have IKEA, you have an IKEA. There's also a Trafidi app for that. If you have a smart home television, it has also an app for that. So it gives you a lot of apps. And yeah, I really don't like that because you have to install it all on your phone and they send all data to the cloud. I want to work my lights when it goes when the internet goes down. I still want to manage them, and also I want to have the information out the cloud, and I want it on my own system. If we look to the vision of Home Assistant, I really like that because it's open source, so I can also see what they are really doing, and it's prioritize privacy. So. And you can run it locally. So I really like them, so I start using the software. A little bit of the history of Home Assistant. Home Assistant is created by... what the big thing is the guy that created it, I mentioned it later, it's starting making a script. And just saying, okay, my lights, I have a button on it, but I want to automate it. I want to automate it when the sun goes down. So he started using Python to make a simple script, and he said, okay, I have a script, but I really want an Android app for it. So he created an Android app, and if you see it, it's a Tasker app. And then he said, okay, but the next thing, I want to more let it be nicer. So he thought everybody is using Bootstrap. I should also be using Bootstrap. So he converted his script to a web program and used the Bootstrap template, and then he put it on GitHub, and yeah, people started using it. But then Google came, and Google made Material UI. And the Material UI was a big booming because a lot of people mentioned this project on GitHub and is starting using it, so it's becoming very large. Okay, let's talk about something about the architecture of it. You see here, it's home console. That's all things where things happened. When the home control gets information, send it back to the home automation, and home automations, based on the user configuration, send command back to the home console. And home control sends commands to lights, switches, and many, many more. If we look to the home architecture from the architecture from Home Assistant, you see there is a large block, its components. There is a lot of code in that, and it's most code is in there. And if you see there, it's the same, it's at set state. It's at state, if you have your alarm system, the alarm goes off, it sets the state to the state machine, and state machine says, okay, the state has changed because the alarm goes off. And then the event bus sends it also back to another component or can send it to the registry. For example, if your alarm goes off, you can send yourself a text message, or you can ring some bells in your house, or you make a phone call. That is a little bit about the architecture of Home Assistant. If you want to run your Home Assistant, you can run it on your Raspberry Pi. They created Hash.io. It's a containerized OS, and you can put it on an SD card, and yes, put the SD card in your Raspberry Pi, and you're up and running. Also, they're also creating a PyPI library for the PyPI, so that you can install with one command, and you have your own environment, so you can do your own stuff in it. But it's also they also have a Docker container, and I'm using the Docker container in my Kubernetes platform on Rancher. And those three options you have, so it's very easy to start. And if you run it, then you are up and running. You just type in your IP address. You type in the IP address 20.8.1.2.3, and you are up and running. And you can manage it with any device. The configuration is also, can you also do web-based, but I don't like it, and most of the people don't like it because we want to code. Luckily, all is done in YAML files. You are able to do it also in Python, but the main configuration is sending in YAML files. If you look to behind me, you see that there is a component, Home Assistant, and has a lot of variables. And that is how the configuration works. It has a component and variables. So it's very easy to understand, but you can also use Jinja in it. Okay, an example. We go to a Home Assistant, to Hash.io, and if I type in tone, then I get a lot of components that I can use. You see here also that there are a lot of available, so if you have something that you want to hook up, probably somebody has created it for you. So, okay, tone. If you don't familiar with tone, tone is a thermostat on your wall, and you can see a lot of information about how many gas you use, or how many power you use, of what the temperature is, and you can also manage your program in it. Okay, I've clicked on the tone. I see more information, what the component is doing, what state is given, and how many values you give. But what I'm really interested in is about the configuration files, is this one. If I'm using that one, I can use it in my configuration file. I just type in my component, I type in my client ID, I use my secret file for that. And when I restarted my Home Assistant, bam, I have my information right where I wanted. I see here, you get my temperature, my gas usage, about what state is on. So that is quite nice, but I want to have a dashboard. I want to have nice widgets on it. So that's why you can select widgets. And those widgets, there are tons of them. I'm using, at my home, I'm using that one, the Tone Thermostat, because I want to see how much my wife is using, is she at home on energy and gas. But but there are also people liking Nest, and there are tons more on Foras and like that. To give you an example about how many widgets you can use, they call it cards on the dashboard. This is an example. This is for your music player, if you have Fitbit, but you can also use it in Google Fit, but there are tons and tons more. Also, you have plant cards, and I really like them, because I have here a sensor for my plant, because I'm really bad in giving my plants water. They die every time again, so I spend a lot of money, but I bought this on AliExpress, and they sent a Bluetooth signal if what the moisture level is. So I really like that, because I can do something with that signal. So I will tell you later on how I get that single for my plants. And also for the beer lovers, there is a depth chart for that. So if you want to track to your favorite beer, it's also possible in Hezo. Okay. Different style, you can make it complete your own. If you want to use infographics, be my guest. If you want to use pictures, you can also use that. Change colors. You can even use Jinja, what I mentioned earlier, to your card. Before this, Jinja is goes about give you dynamically key, how many miles you are from home and from work. But you can also use it to mention yourself which devices have low battery. It's all possible. This is my setup at home. You see here my Thome thermostat again. You see, I also my bus stops, and I really like that because otherwise I had to take 4 or 5 steps to find out when my first bus goes. This was actually not working well, so I helped the guy that created it, and I said, "Hey, good idea, but I'm missing some information, and the confirmation is not quite working yet. But I have an idea, so I sent them my plan of how we can manage that." And I also told. Asked them if I, if I may change his code, but a few hours back later I get a message from him. Oh, thank you, Ralph. If I just added updated my components and it's working now, so I was very happy about it. Same thing to Afval. It's rest in Groningen. It was not working in Groningen, but I have sent him an email and asked if I can help him, and it was also updated and it's working again. So. Yeah, I really like that because my Onkyo, I'm very lazy guy. I don't like remote controls. I just type in if I'm awake and I tap in NOS and it said it grabs the latest news feed. It's put on my television, it put on my transceiver and everything is working and I can take some food and it plays. Okay, my deal with your own. If you, I have a few products that I do myself. One of the things is that I have here a Raspberry Pi, It's an Arduino ASP32 with a camera on it. You can hook up your sensors, as you see here. I have here hook up the sensors for my click-on, click-out system, but you can also, there's a Bluetooth chip in it for receiving the signals from my plant sensor. You can also run it with MicroPython. It's also working very fine. I have a Mi Light hub for my Mi Light light bulbs to switch it on and off. And I'm also using it for my Nano Reef for my fish to feed them automatically, to turn on the lights and stuff like that. Does it always work? Most of the time, yes. Sometimes I make mistakes and yeah. This light is, you see there, it was red, but it should be white, so yeah. But it's fun to learn, and most of the mistakes, I make them myself, and sometimes components are broken or not working like expected, but it's Python, so I can fix it by my own, but a lot of other people are working with those projects, so if there is something broken, they will be fixed. Okay, that was the first thing about my talk. The second part is about being in community. Make it easy to communicate and don't be a dick. When you start on a community project, a lot of people is trying to using your software, and a lot of beginners like me are starting using software and make a lot of mistakes. But you have to have a platform where you can communicate with each other. First thing, what you see in a lot of projects like Home Assistant is using a forum for talking, communication. But don't be a dick if somebody makes a mistake. There's a lot of mistakes making, and try to help people to get started. And if they make mistakes, yes, be kind, be nice. And yeah, the last thing I mentioned is good documentation. We don't like that, but it's yeah, a really important one. The guy, Daniello, I have seen a talk from him at the EuroPython last year in Scotland. And yeah, he was talking about good documentation. And he said, yeah, if you don't have good documentation, people won't come and use it. So your community is never going to be growing. So he taught me two important things in those tutorials, and he said, if you start a tutorial, it's as simple, but it must always work, because if a people is trying to do a tutorial and it's work, he said, yes, it's working. But if its tutorial is not working, yes, people stopping using your software and never look at it again. And also, make good how-to tutorials. How-to guides. If you have an how-to guide, it should be easy for people to understand, so that they can do simple tasks. And if they have done that, then will they go further in your code? Okay, my contribution. I have using a meteor alarm for my to get weather alerts in the Netherlands. It's nice that meteor alarm grabs all the information from whole Europe, because I thought, I want to write something in Home Assistant, but I want to do something with my weather alert in the Netherlands. Because if you are working at Duo and it's code red, you are not allowed to go to the building because you have to work at home. So I thought, maybe I can write something for that. So what I did is, can I make a sensor of it, that if it goes red, that I can grab this information and send me a text message on my phone and, for example, call on my light red. Okay, so I thought about that, and I thought, let's do it, because they have a very nice XML output that you can request from the website. So I think, let's do it. So those are things that I really needed. I needed a GitHub repo for my PyPy library, because Home Assistant is requiring that you grabbing PyPy libraries, because they want to have the components so clean as possible. I'm using Travis CI for automatic testing, but also for automatic uploading it to PyPy, because I don't like to do it manually. I am lazy, as I mentioned earlier, so I want to automate that. So I'm using Travis CI for it. I'm using also PyPy, what I mentioned earlier, and of course I need to make a component for that to grab this information from PyPy, for my library that I will write on. Okay, here's my code. I'm not proud of it. I should hide it, because this is a practical explanation about how not to write Python code, because I started the code and I thought, I make one simple for loop for it, and it worked, but then I started another for loop, and another for loop, and my colleagues were laughing at me. He said, "Rolf, you never write your Python code like that." Sorry. I have not haven't time to clean it up, but it worked, because when I run Python 3 tests, I get a dict information, and that information is exactly the information that I need, because I know what I want to can color my lights. I get the message that I can send to me, and I said to my colleagues, you don't like my code? It's on GitHub. So if you want to do a contribution, you are welcome. So I have my PyPy package ready. So the next thing that I did is I opened Travis CI, or I want to integrate with Travis CI, so I created this file. And this file will automatically testing my code in 2.7, 3.6. Why I did that, because I have concentrated myself on 3.6, but I saw that it is broken on 2.7, so I can easily fix it, because Travis said it was your code was not working, so that was a good point from Travis. Also, you see here, when I add tags on it, when I tagged the code on GitHub, it will also send me it automatically to PyPy. So I really like that, because the only thing that I have to do is to manage it on GitHub, and it's also automatically put to PyPy. Does traffic work? It's working fine, and it's working very nicely, and it's also automatically upload my code to Py, so I was very happy. Okay, next thing. If you want to work with Home Assistant, you want to do a contribution to it, you have to make a fork of it. So I make a fork, I use the dev branch from them, and then I use Git to get the code to my home, and then I can start my own component. So this is the code that I use for my component. As you see, it's more cleaner. I have a lot of done more time and effort in this code. And one of the most important things is that the attributes that I get earlier is giving back to the Home Assistant by those one. It says, okay, this attributes are filled by alert, and alert is my it's requesting my API from my PyPy, and it's standing above the code that you need to require your country code and your province name, and when you put that in, okay. Then you can test it in Home Assistant, and it was actually working. So I was very happy about it, because yes, and now I'm able to call on my lights to, if there's a weather alert, whoosh, lights goes red, or some of a red alert, I can send text message to my TV or my phone or everything about that. But I thought, yeah, okay, but it's fun to create it for myself, but it's more fun to share it to the community. So next thing was that I share it. So I opened a pull request and I saw all those templates with a lot of rules and messages and tests. And I said, yeah, but it's so simple. So I cleared all those things up and I sent a message. And then I make a classic mistake because of this. One of the guys on Home Assistant sent me a message back on GitHub and said, oh, Rolf, thank you for sending a contribution to us. But why have you deleted our template? Because we cannot automatically test your code, and also we're missing some other information from you. Yeah, okay. So it was very nice. He was not a dick, but yeah, I thought about myself. Yeah, RTFM. Yeah, a classic mistake, Rolf. You have to read. So I did it again. I fill all everything in, and then I press submit, and then I have to wait. I'll wait for a long time because, yeah, then the automatic test will run. And because it's so large project from Home Assistant, there's so many new components or fixes that some checks can take a couple of hours. Because if you look in the list of how many tests will be done, it's still growing. So, but after a few tests, I thought, oh, now it's waiting for approval, and if it's approved, my code is in Home Assistant, but yeah, because this is a community, other people has comments on your code. Yeah, and this one, he said, okay, you have to do less commenting. You have to write more that in your documentation. So I also wrote more documentation on that, and. And there was more people that has commented to my component. One of the things that I has created a sensor, so I was really happy about that. And then some discussion has gone on, and they said, "Yeah, nice sensor, but it must be a binary sensor." And I thought, "Oh no," because I was just starting it, and now I have to read how a binary sensor was working. So it cost me a lot of time and a lot of energy to do that. I was working on Friday, Saturday, Sunday and Monday on it, so that takes me a lot of time, but it was finally working. But I get a little bit tired of it, because I said, yeah, just accept my change, because I wanted to run in my Home Assistant. And I said, okay, Rolf, I was finally there that I said, oh, everything is ready. And yeah, one of the guys said, yeah, you have a typo in it, you have to make it make a dash within it, so I tell search and replace, and then whoosh, everything went broke, and that is a thing. The thing that Alfmi, the CEO, he said, okay, you have to test before publishing, because yeah, he said, yeah, you have now broken your complete component, because I asked you to change one thing and you change everything. Yeah, okay, and then I said, okay, I thought, oh, but they said, don't be a dick. Okay, you're right, I did now a first test and everything seems okay now. And I can tell you now that the code is actually in the dev branch now, and it's released in the beta. So in the next few days, it will be released in a new release. So I'm very happy, because it cost me a lot of energy, But I get a lot of energy back because I said, a lot of people in Europe in Home Assistant can finally using my first own created components. But how I automated my wife? I got a lot of questions also from my colleagues that do from that. If I go from work and I go at home, I get a lot of discussion if I come home. Yeah, why have you sent me a text message that you're going to home? I said, yeah, okay, but okay, I will do that tomorrow. And then I come back tomorrow and I step in my house. Oh yeah, I send you a text message. Yeah, you need to change because you know the discussions there. So, okay. So I thought, okay, but yeah, I can try to change myself, but I thought, oh, can Home Assistant kind of assist me with this? Because I have a Google Maps app on my phone. I have a Home Assistant running at my home. I have Google Home that talks in my home. So what I create is this little YAML file, and it's just looking for it's looking for my device. If I'm leaving from work at home at this time, it shows, okay, Rolf is not now coming home. So it sets the following to Darius on his way home. He has been seen at, and it's be on all speakers at home. So you can mention if my daughter is watching television, she said, oh, this is not very happy about it. But my wife knows that I'm leaving my work, so she can start cooking. So if I come home, my dinner is ready. How nice is that? I haven't done it ever to be changed, but Home Assistant did a lot of job for me. That okay. Special thanks. Oh, so now I can make a mistake again. Thanks, but my English is not that good, and this is one of the jokes my college makes because they said, "Yeah, Rolf, you have to make sure that you speak the words right." So that was one of the jokes. Paulus. Yeah, he's wrote in all the program and he started using the script. I'm really happy about that he started it, and he's also using that software, and he's really contributing that for the community, also my colleagues, and also the people that are helping me out on the community for making this component to get it working. If you want to know more about Domotica, or you want to know more about Home Assistant or the electronics that I just show you, there is actually a meetup here in Groningen. You can feel free to join them. Quite some fun people, also a lot of people that are using Python and also Home Assistant, but also other products. It's there. Okay, I'm now reaching the point that there can be questions, but I don't know if there is time for that.
We have time for one or two questions, yes.
First of all, really cool talk. I'm also having a home automation system at home.
Yes.
And then I had to make a choice between different systems, and I actually chose OpenHAB. I'm not sure if you know that.
Yeah.
But a colleague of mine said, you should try this. And then I'm not sure. So did you ever try OpenHAB, or what is your opinion on that? It's Java based and it's a bit heavy. Sometimes it stops and maybe I should switch, but what do you think? Basically, that's the question.
There are people at the meetup in Domotica in Grun that are using Home OpenHAB. But I believe you have to pay for it or not. Yeah, because they are still also looking to use Home Assistant, because OpenHAB, it's not that big community that Home Assistant has. It's still growing. I have now seen what kind of components is now releasing in the next release. It's huge, and it's still being big. But also, a lot of guys that creating APIs on systems that don't have APIs. So I really like that, because not all products are working with normal home automation, but a lot of guys make it happen. And if that goes broken because there's something changed in the HTML file, there are guys that fixing it. So yeah, it's run really stable, and I have not seen any big problems with it.
Final question. I have one question left. Maybe you said it's important for the community to have some kind of to be open for communication. There's a lot of tools for communication, right? You can do anything from Gitter to whatever, Twitter or what do you recommend? If you would start like an open source project, what would be like the default place to go for? What would you open up for communication?
Yeah, one of the things that Paulus did, he mentioned that he had run into problems because he was using first a mailing list, and he said, yeah, that's gonna be don't work. So he started just a forum so that people can start using a forum, and he's using the Discord chat. It's normally a chat for games, but he's using it for Home Assistant, and I was really happy about it because I had some problems. I sent it also on the chat, and the guys, oh, Rolf, you have to mention that you change, if you change that, you have to change also that. Oh! So that was really nice that Paulus did that, because yeah, he said you need to have some other platform besides GitHub to let people talk to each other.
Exactly. Okay, thank you very much. Like a warm hand.
Thank you. Yeah.